Hi children, after the lockdown we have come back to the studies again. You class 10 have chapter 2 continuity of life, where today we will discuss the reproduction, asexual reproduction, along with the sexual reproduction little bit, and the vegetative reproduction, that is vegetative propagation, natural and artificial. Let us discuss what is the concept, what is reproduction, why is it required. Concept of reproduction is given actually by the nature, because in nature the various living things are there. The diversity of living things are going on and on. This is known as the continuation of the generation. The continuation of the generation means that I have come from my father, and from me some offsprings will come, and like this it will go. In plants, in animals, in very small organisms like the microorganisms and all those, they have the same process, because they keep their generation. The concept is the keeping the generation. Concept of reproduction is keeping the generation for the future. And then this is how it goes. If there was no reproduction, the earth slowly and gradually would have been no living things on the surface, and it would have been a desolate place. So reproduction, the concept, is a boon of the nature had given to the living organisms. Let us discuss about the modes of reproduction. There are basically two modes of reproduction are there. One is the asexual reproduction, the other one is the sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction also, we must say there is another type of reproduction which belongs to asexual part, is called a third type of reproduction, which is known as the vegetative reproduction. That is done in plants only, by plant body parts like root, stem, leaf, etc. Now here you see, in asexual reproduction only one parent is required. There is no need to have the male and female and all those. Only one parent is required. That is why it is asexual reproduction. In plants, the asexual reproduction, I mean single parent plant, does it by the formation of the spores, motile or non-motile spores. In different species, different types of spores they make. Like the example is mucor. Mucor is a fungi. You see the diagram of the mucor will be like this almost. This is the diagram of mucor. Will come out on the substrate like that, IV and all. So this is mucor, and this part is known as the sporangium. What is known as sporangium? Sporangium is a place where the spores are kept, and the spores grow and mature there. At maturity, the sporangium bursts and the spores come out to new offspring. That means the new individuals. Alright, then we have in animals, there is also asexual reproduction is there. In amoeba, what we have already observed, in amoeba there are two kinds of asexual reproduction. They do, number one, the binary fission. Bi means two, binary fission means dividing into two. The mother cell, that means the original amoeba, at maturity divides into two daughter cells, that is known as binary fission. It will be like this. Suppose this is amoeba, and at maturity it will go slowly and gradually, it will be divided into two. Finally, it will come out as to different cells. So this is binary fission. That is, one mother cell has been divided into two daughter cells. So that is binary fission. Except of that, all organisms, they go through a unfavorable time in the life. So amoeba also undergo unfavorable condition. In unfavorable condition, they have a condition that they can undergo to make a cyst. In the cyst, that is the coating they make around their body by themselves, and they keep there in a almost dormant form. There they stay until the favorable conditions come. But you know, during this, they do one thing, they divide into many in numbers in one spore, and that when the favorable conditions come, the spore bursts, and along with that, the many cells come out. This is known as multiple fission. So this one is binary fission. And another one, which I have already called, that is multiple fission. In multiple fission, that is, they come out in many a number. So that is, binary means two, multiple means many a number. Well, then we have in organisms like hydra and yeast. Yeast, you know, is a very, very common material. It's a fungi, and it is used in all kinds of bakery products, bread, cake, and all those. Why, you know? Because yeast, if it is put, it undergoes two processes. One is fermentation, and another one is it undergoes anaerobic respiration, by which it leaves the carbon dioxide through the dough of the bread and all. So it swells up, and when you take a slice of the cake or bread, you see there are gaps are there. You minutely see there are gaps are there, small pocket like gaps are there. Those gaps are nothing but as the carbon dioxide was produced and that had gone out of the bread, so making the holes there. So yeast is a fungi, and that goes actually having budding. In hydra, amazing creature, they are lovely, I mean locomotory program. Hydra, the drawing is like this. Tentacles are there, and these tentacles, they range from 4 to 11. 4 to 11, remember my child, 4 to 11. In some cases, when the hydra is small, the tentacles may be less, but at best it can be up to 11. So tentacle ranges from 4 to 11. So whatsoever it is, 4 or 11 or 6 and 7, commonly it is 6 and 7, young hydra. And then the hydra, it's an amazing creature. It has, it's not unicellular, it's multicellular but very small. And then this organism has beautiful locomotory system. It undergoes and protects by locomotion. It moves by its tentacles, by swaying down the tentacles like this. Tentacles they put on the surface, and they move like this. Again the base comes like this. So this is called sliding movement. Like this they do, sliding movement. You have seen in leech also, sliding movement. Well, after the sliding movement, they have an amazing kind of movement is there, which is known as somersault. Like that they bend and they do somersault. You tell in Hindi kalabaiya, like this. Somersault, they do the somersault and get progress. That is the somersault movement. And except of that, they have a special movement as they live in the water. So sometimes the water in a jhil or pool gets warm in one corner. So to keep themselves aloof from the water, they release the gas from their anal pore, and it forms like a balloon which floats them from one corner to the other corner of the pool so that they are saved from the heat. That is called the movement by releasing the gas from the anal pool. So they release the gas from the substratum, make a balloon-like structure, and then the balloon-like structure with the air that is moved to the cooler side of the pool. The third one, if it is known as trapeze movement, my dear children, have you seen circus sometimes? Yes, you have seen, or sometimes you have seen in TV also. In circus, you see some players, they do the trapeze movement. In there are bars, parallel bars, high on that, they move, and sometimes they hold the bar and just climb up with the body is parallel or horizontal to the surface. That is the do. The hydra is that amazing creature, it does like that also. The plants inside the water, there are inside the water some plants are there, they hold that with the tentacle. They hold that with the tentacle and they climb up to save them from the heat of the water, and this is how they are saved. So this hydra actually reproduces asexually by budding. So hydra reproduces by budding. Suppose say this is the hydra, suddenly the part swells up and slowly and gradually this grows in. This is how it comes out, and finally they detach from the mother hydra. They detach from the mother hydra. So detached from the mother hydra. So this is called budding. This is known as budding in hydra. If the hydra by accident goes to collide with something and it's broken into parts, then fragments of hydra can grow into new hydra. That is known as fragmentation. So there are two processes of asexual reproduction existing in hydra. It is the budding and the fragmentation. Budding and the fragmentation are the two processes. All right. So after that, we have come to know little bit about the sexual reproduction. We told you that in asexual reproduction, single parent spores, motile and non-motile, are produced. But in case of the sexual reproduction, involves the male and female individuals. Male and female individuals are involved and forming the reproductive cell, which are known as the gametes. Males form male gametes, females form female gametes, and then male plus female gamete together forms a special cell which is known as zygote, The making of the zygote is known as, the process is known as the fertilization. What is known as fertilization? So fertilization is the process where the male and female gametes in sexual reproduction unites to form the zygote. That is about the sexual reproduction. All right. And then it involves all eukaryotes. The eukaryotes means the organisms which has complete advanced cells. They may be plants, they may be animals, anything else. They are eukaryotes. So eukaryotic cells are there, and then they form in animals sperm, which is a male gamete, and ovum, which is a female gamete, and these two gets together to form a zygote by the process fertilization. Well, let us little bit see about the sexual and the asexual reproduction. So we know about the difference between the sexual and the asexual reproduction are like this. Asexual reproduction, single parent. Sexual reproduction, involvement of the male and female both. So in asexual reproduction, there are spore formation of different kinds of spores, motile motile spore, non-motile spore, etc. In sexual reproduction, the formation of the male and female gametes. Male gametes known as the sperms in human beings and ovum in the females. Like that in other organisms also the same. So they unite together to form a special cell which is known as zygote. And the zygote, after divisions, they come to form the individuals. All right. Let us study right now the vegetative propagation. What I asked, I already have narrated you the third type of reproduction, which is also asexual reproduction in plants, is there, which is known as vegetative reproduction, known as the vegetative propagation. The vegetative propagation are of two types. One is naturally occurring, natural process of vegetative propagation. The another one is artificial vegetative propagation. In artificial vegetative propagation is the vegetative propagation that is done by the human beings, and the natural, it occurs naturally, and they involve the root. Naturally, natural propagation occurs naturally. They involve the roots, root of tuber of the sweet potato. Sweet potato is a root. Its tuber forms into new plants. So it is from the tuber. In stem, there are many types. Stem, lamb, that means terrestrial one. The stem cutting of rose plant and all those is there. And then if you put the stem cutting of the rose plant into a place where water and the supply of the water is there continuously, it will grow up into a rose plant. So that is stem cutting. And then we have in water plant, have you seen water hyacinth? In during the rainy season, they float in the water, and sometimes in ponds and all those, they make so huge vegetation that it looks like a field, but it is not. It is a water hyacinth, and water hyacinth also reproduces by the stem, and that is stem that stay in water, and the stem that stay underground, like potato tuber. Have you seen potato tuber, ginger, potato? These are all the underground stems. They are also modified stems because they store the food for the future. Well, the potato tuber, if you take in your hand, you will see there are eyes. Suppose say this is a potato, especially from my own field, and you see there are ridges like this you will find on the body of the potato. And these ridges are known as the eyes. What are they known as? Eyes in potato. Eyes. What are these eyes? Underground stem. What are these eyes? Eyes are nothing but axillary buds. What are they? They are axillary buds, and these axillary buds come into new plants when it is needed. So that is why tuber potato. And that by buds are known as the axillary buds, and they are called eyes. Okay. Now in terrestrial plants, some stems like the runner and the stolon, they also grow. Like, you know, the runner is grass. See, dope grass by which the offerings is done, puja and all those offerings are done, that is runner. And also the strawberry plant. Strawberry, you know, a lovely fruit attribute. The strawberry also a runner. So they also produce by the strawberry plant. So this is by the stem. This is by the stem. And then after this stem will come to leaf. Well, after the stem, we have to come on the leaves, because the leaf also can produce new plants in the vegetative propagation. Here you see in leaves, adventitious buds are there. Have you ever seen bryophyllum leaf? A green color, red veined leaf, just having little bit of dented part at the lamina. From this dented part, the adventitious buds are there. This is bryophyllum leaf. This leaves are known as bryophyllum, and they produce from the buds the new plants. This is the vegetative propagation, natural vegetative propagation for the bryophyllum through the leaf. So we have come to know about the vegetative natural propagation through the root. Then we have come to know about the stem, and we have also come to know about the vegetative production by the leaf. Now we will move to the artificial propagation. Now human beings are always ambitious. Suppose you have a beautiful mango plant. The mango is very, very tasty, but it is not in very big condition, that it is not a very big size one, or the number of mangoes are less, but it is very tasty. Then what human beings have done by artificial propagation, they have taken, chosen the species where mangoes are good size, many mangoes are there, and then they started producing it by doing the hybridization in various ways. By that is we are going to discuss. Not only for mangoes, there are different things that they work. Alright, number one, cutting. So first is the stem cutting. In general plants like rose and all, the stem cutting is done, and the stem cutting usually is put where the plenty of supply of water is there. And for the stem cutting of rose, they are producing the new plants. Okay, now after this, there are two kinds of layering is there, ground and air layering. That's ground layering and air layering. Ground layering is done in apple root stalks. In apple root stalks, the ground layering is done. What do they do? Forces the side buds to grow upward, and then in the that is how they do. And as the buds grow up slowly and gradually, then they take it out from there and put to form the new plants. Alright, now we have the air layering, which is known as the goti or the marcotti. The target region of a certain plant is cut 4 cm long, open with a toothpick. They put the toothpick over there, and as they surrounded the wound with a moisture retaining medium, which is known as sphagnum moss. Or if there is no sphagnum moss, they can put cloth around it. Alright, and plastic film. Why plastic film? To prevent moisture, because if the moisture is there, slowly and gradually the chances of the roots to come out will be more. And so to prevent the loss of the moisture, and rooting hormone is applied. Now here the use of hormone is there. Rooting hormone is used and stem is removed and planted with care. So after rooting hormone, some days they wait to get the roots out from there, and the part of the stem with the root where the roots are come out, they scoop out or cut out and put it and plant it to the new field where they can get the new plants. All right. Now we have grafting. As I was giving an example, if the people have very good mango, suppose one, I have a plant where very beautiful tasty mango is there, lovely, good smell, very sweet, good mango is there, but the number of the mango is very less in the plant. And on the other hand, we have find another plant where the mango is not tasty, sir, but lots of mango are there and they are in good size. So what? The grafting is the process that can be done in this case to increase the number of mangoes, keep the taste same and the smell and all the same. So obviously there are several tries you will have to there, and that is the process of grafting. What is doing in the grafting? Especially in the rainy season, they cut little bit of obliquely this way. Suppose that this is a branch, they cut it little bit obliquely like this. This way they cut, and then they put it along with the another branch of the tree like this, and they fasten there with a cloth, sometimes straw, and even in desi process they mix the dry cow dung along with that of very good earth or soil, and they mix and they put there, and by straw they surround it and put it with a small rope and let them continuous water supply be done. Nowadays the hormone is also produced, and in course of time the roots will come out from here and when the roots will come out, they will cut it from there and it will be planted. This is known as grafting. In common language, this is known as column. So this is how they do. Now, micro propagation. After all this natural propagation, artificial propagation, we have the micro propagation. In micro propagation, a solution medium is made with essential nutrients and phytohormones, and all those are put together. And then there, the selected pieces of cut from the plant body is taken and put the nutrients and phytohormones there in aseptic condition. In aseptic condition, they do. And then what do? This is known as the callus tissue. And this tissue, there to put auxin, the hormone, and also the cytokinin. These two hormones are put. And the process is known as the tissue culture. This is known as the tissue culture. You know, generally the monocotyledonous plants, the plants which is having seeds, having one seed coat, these are like coconut and other monocotyledonous plant. They have no cambial tissue. Xylem and phloem is there for conduction of the water and the conduction of the food, prepared food, but no cambium is there. So if there is no cambium, the other grafting and all those cannot be done. So they undergo the tissue culture. So coconut and other monocot plants, because no cambial tissue is there, they are cultured. So this is how by the artificial culture, the coconut plant and other monocot plants, which are desirable for the human beings, they make. That is all about the vegetative propagation. So after the artificial propagation, vegetative propagation, we have already explained about the cutting, grafting, micropropagation, all those. We come to alternation of generation. Now, what is alternation of generation? That is to be known as some organisms, you see, they go saprophytic generation at first, where they produce the diploid phase. Usually they produce the spores of different type, that is motile spore, non-motile spore, etc. While in gametophytic generation, we have the haploid phase, that is gametes. The males produce male gametes. In human beings, the male gametes are known as the sperm, while the females produce the ovum. So male and female gametes are produced. So that is gametophytic generation. While that is what they occurs in both plants and animals, because plants do have also sexual reproduction. When we are going to discuss the sexual reproduction, we'll discuss this again. Now we have occurs in plants and animals, and in animals, you know, that is definitely the gametophytic generation is there, because male female gametes forming zygote, and then zygote to develop to new organism. Now isomorphic and heteromorphic alternation of generation is there. Ectocarpus is a plant. It's there. It is found in the isomorphic generation. That means the similar type. And heteromorphic, that different one. So that is, hetero means different. And that is found in the mosses. That is what is due for the alternation of generation. Thank you and have a good day.